This is one of the most interesting cars I've driven this year, and it could be the best car Porsche makes today. This is the Cayman GTS. Don't think that this GTS is just a trim package. Now, this car has a lot of standard performance options as well as trim that make it a very compelling package. The GTS enhances and amplifies everything the Cayman is known for, and with the near $13,000 higher price tag, it's optimized with a long list of equipment that would otherwise be optional. In fact, the GTS's standard equipment is the equivalent of over $14,000 in Cayman S options, and you get the bump in power output for free. In the GTS, the 3.4-liter flat six makes 15 more horsepower than the Cayman S for a total of 340, and torque is up to 280 pounds-feet. Porsche makes its sport exhaust optional in other Caymans, but the way it enhances the exhaust note and all of the pops and burbles on overrun, it is rightly fitted as original equipment to the GTS. Beyond the mild power bump and the black trim, the GTS is all about the details. Noticeably, the new front fascia adds some welcome aggressiveness to this Cayman. The Cayman GTS's cockpit is one of the most effective and attractive in the business. You sit perfectly behind the wheel, and yards of Alcantara are fitted to the steering wheel, shifter, headliner, and seats. The high level of interior finishes make this cabin simply gorgeous. The way this Cayman GTS is spec'd is very much the way I would specify one as well. It's got all the right options. Of course, it's got a manual transmission, and with this mid-engine, it is just outstanding. Porsche's active suspension management system, a long name for electronically controlled dampers, is also standard, and its three modes are noticeably distinct from one another, unlike some competitive systems. The no-cost sport chassis option lowers the GTS by 10 millimeters over the standard Cayman S. Sport Chrono is standard and includes Porsche's dynamic gearbox mounts. Instead of a standard mount, these use different levels of firmness and optimize the settings between comfort and drivetrain response. There's nothing worse than a sloppy feel from a sports car shifter when you're putting it under serious load, and these work great. The GTS is a sports car with exceptional performance and dynamics, with much credit due to its mid-engine layout. It's got massively high limits, and once you're on edge, at least for me, you can confidently play with this car. The controls are so precise and feedback so detailed that you can expertly cut any corner, and it's a blast to drive, novice and expert alike. Just listen to that. This thing is such a great package. It's something you can drive every day, something you can take to the racetrack and have a lot of fun with, and it's completely functional as well. You've got a trunk in the front and the rear. It's just an all-around fantastic sports car. One thing I will say is that the Cayman GTS I tested in Europe was fitted with amazing carbon buckets. We don't get them here, and it's something Porsche should really make available. Still, to me, this is the ultimate Cayman and perhaps the ultimate do-it-all Porsche, and I love the spec of this GTS. Alcantara interior, manual transmission, and the lower suspension, never mind the brilliant sounding exhaust.
although there are some competitors like the Corvette Stingray and BMW M4 that are more powerful and equally formidable performance cars, their front engine, rear drive layouts can never offer the same complete, quick, and confident personality that defines the Cayman GTS.
Thanks for watching our short film about the Porsche Cayman GTS, and we hope you liked it. If you did like it, be sure to like it and share it as well. And we want to know what you think, so please leave a comment. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you again next time.